Hello everyone. In this video, we will introduce a concept used in computed tomography, the Hounsfield Unit. Previously, we have seen that CT scanners use a set of software algorithms to calculate the amount of X-ray radiation absorbed by every element of a tissue slice. Each of these elements is represented by a pixel or voxel. Each pixel or voxel is assigned a numerical value called a CT number. This CT number is compared to the attenuation value of water and is displayed on a scale of arbitrary units named Hounsfield Unit or HU. The HU scale is applied to the CT data by scaling all measured attenuation coefficients from a tissue slice to the attenuation of water using this equation. From the equations, the CT number from a pixel now is in HU scale and is proportional to the measured attenuation coefficients in this pixel, scaled by the attenuation coefficient of the water. It was Sir Godfrey Hounsfield who developed this scale. Here is an example of the Hounsfield scale applied to several body parts. As you can see, the HU of water is set to zero, while the HU of air is set to minus 1000. The HU of bone is typically greater than 500. Fat and fatty tissues have HU around minus 100, while soft tissue, composed mostly of water, have HU in the range of 0 to 100. The contrast between soft tissue with HU value from 0 to 100 often challenges the resolution of CT scanners. Let's take an example of gray and white matters in the brain. The gray matters, which has a pinkish gray color, contains nerve cell bodies, whereas the white matter is made of connection axons transporting information between different parts of the brain. Both are soft tissue in the brain, and the difference between the two is approximately 5 to 10 HUs. So the contrast resolution of the CT scanners need to be high to pick up such a small difference. As usual, the technology has improved a lot. In the new scanners, the scale can now extend in the positive direction to about plus 4000, which represent very dense metal. The range of HU values or CT numbers displayed in a CT image is called window. In the clinic, the radiologist uses a software that automatically assigns HU values between minus 1000 and over 1000 to every voxel of a CT image in order to analyze the data. Tissues that strongly absorb X-rays, such as bone, appear white, while others that absorb poorly, such as air, appear black. During a CT scan, the radiographer will set up the imaging parameters and a monitor will display the settings. This process is called windowing. With two important factors displayed during this process, the first factor W represents the window width. It describes the range of CT numbers display in different shades of gray, ranging from black to white. It means that if the radiographer reduces the window width, the contrast among tissue will increase. The second factor, L, is the window level. It controls and adjusts the center of the window width. This factor can be used to optimize the image contrast within an organ. In practice, a variety of different values of L and W are used. And for example, during bone imaging, W will be set to 2500 and L 2000 HU. And the window will be shifted up towards the white scale. The main reason windowing is used is to improve contrast sensitivity. The window can be set to display very small differences in tissue densities. For example, during lung imaging, the same image here is viewed with different values of window parameters. The first image on the left was taken with the pulmonary window. W was set to 1600 and L set to minus 600. You will note that the lungs can be clearly seen, as well as a dense area in the right upper lung. Now, let's have a look at the same image, but taken with a different window. W here was set to 350 and L was set to 50. As you can see, just by changing the window values, the lung has disappeared. But now, in this new window, we can clearly see a tumor. To summarize, I hope that the overview of CT scanning process is now becoming clearer. The formation of CT images takes three major steps. The first step consists of scanning the patient using an X-ray source set to a fixed voltage and current. During scanning, the electrical signal collected by the detector are stored in a computer as scan data. The second step is to reassemble or reconstruct the collected data stored in the computer. A method called filtered back projections is used in this step, producing a digital image, also called 3D volume. The last step is the conversion of a digital image into a visible image, also called analog image. The final display of this image is made possible by using windowing parameters such as window width and window level, applied to specific clinical settings. I hope that you now have a better understanding of the different steps on CT scanning. In the next part of the course, we will introduce contrast agents and how they are used to improve a CT image quality.